$800 of investment, I'm hoping, comes back to me by taking that off. G'day and welcome to Black Opal Direct. My name's Justin. Well, today I have chosen a piece out of a parcel of rough that I think could cut something quite nice. Now, I've averaged out this parcel so that I could get a price for this piece. And my cost on this piece is $800 if I average it out across the all the other pieces that I got together in this lot. And so my challenge is to try and cut something worth more than $800 out of this piece. And it has some really nice color. And what I am banking on with this stone is for it to turn black inside. Now, I haven't cut some seam opal for a few months now. This is seam opal from the Grawen fields out in, This is seam opal from the Grawen fields out in Lightning Ridge. And seam opal is different to knobby opal. But as you can see, there is still a nice side that has potch and another side that has a little bit more gray, like a cap, similar to a cap from a knobby opal. So I'm going to work on that the same. Now, where it's broken here, you can see that the gray potch has turned into black. So that's telling me that it could, I'm saying could, not definitely, but could be black inside on the color. Now, there's always the chance that there could be a little white line between the black and the color. A little gray line every so often happens and the color doesn't turn black. So you just never know until you get into that stone and start facing it up. So this color is really beautiful. It has green, blue, red, and I'm hoping that I can get a nice red stone out of it. When I shine the flashlight into the color bar, now that color bar is only showing a little bit of color, a little bit of clearness through there. So it could be that it's really, really black inside, even the color bar's black so that it doesn't get through, or there's sand in there. So at $800, I am taking a risk. So let's get on the wheel. I'll take it slowly. Let's go step by step and make sure we don't make any mistakes. All right, let's get on there. All right, so we've got this piece here. You can see there's a little bit of color showing up there. But the main part that I'm liking is this color here. So the plan is for that to be traveling right through to there. And if it does, then we might have a decent sized stone in there. Now, this black potch inside is hopefully touching the color. If that black potch is touching the color, then we may have a winner. Now I can see a smidgen of color showing up just there. And I can see some color here and a little bit of color there. So let's hope that this thing will produce something decent. So what I'm going to start by doing is grinding off the excess that doesn't have any color. So I'll bring that into where the color is there and I'll go around the sides. I always recommend to go around the sides because you can't see anything right now until you start grinding. So let me get that wheel going. So this was what I was concerned about. There is color there, then there's gray, and then there's black. So there is a chance that that black might not touch the color. You can see that color showing up there, which is a good sign. So what's happening now is that potch is slowly coming up to the colour. So if I go further in, I think maybe it might turn black, but we can't be 100% sure. Okay, so the potch on the top is not going to turn any darker than it is, it doesn't look like. So I think we're safe to say that we can take that colour bar down. This is where the gamble starts. My $800 of investment, I'm hoping, comes back to me by taking that off. So let's see how we go. Doing it bit by bit. Making sure I don't make any mistakes. Back is really sharp on my fingers, so I'm just going to smoothen around those edges, because when I push, the sharp edges push into my fingers, which is hurts a bit. So it looks to me like this is not turning black at all. Unfortunately, we are not making any money today. Still very, very nice color. It's not going black, but I'm gonna take it down just a little bit further and see what happens with this color. But I am doubting that it does go any blacker. Wow, okay. This area here is just starting to show some darkness. And that might be the potch starting to show up. Some really interesting colours in there of mauve and pink and red. So there's no colour left on that side. There's a sand spot there, and I have to bring it in pretty much into there and go for the stone that's left there, pretty much. Well, there we go. I've rubbed the piece out and it doesn't go onto the black very well at all. It is a little bit darker than I hoped, but it didn't work out like I hoped, but there is some colors in there that are very, very rare. And pink and mauve are very rare colors in opal, and I don't see it very often. So that could save me on my purchase. So hopefully, when I cut this stone, which we're going to do now, we get our money back and maybe a little bit more. We will have to wait and see. While I sit at my machine, it gives me the space and time to reflect. Right now I'm wondering about the world, and I do hope you are safe. Polishing an opal has such a soothing effect on me. Seeing those curved lines take shape, that shape forms a gem which is meticulously polished and sent all over the world for people to wear and enjoy. I thank my father for my knowledge and ability that he passed to me so that I could share it with you. Because this kind of knowledge would be a shame to leave behind in a forgotten generation. And while I'm cutting this gem, I encourage you to subscribe to my channel. That also encourages me to create more videos for you, so that we can all learn and grow with opal. Because this misunderstood gem is also one of the most unique gems the planet has ever seen. Rightio, so we finished the stone and it was 2.6 carats as a rub. We've got it down to 2.02 carats finished, so it's a 2-carat stone. Now, let's go off the brightness and body tone first. So if I take it onto the body tone scale and we have a look, you can see that it's actually, parts of it is N5, parts of it's N3 on N4. So all over it's a little bit mottly. So we got to come up with some kind of an average there of the whole stone as one piece. So we could call one part of it an N5 because the grey potch is there in the colour. And then we could say N2 or N3 where the black potch is and the black colour is. So I would bring this around about to an N4 just because of the fact that there is lightness and there is more darkness in there as well. So let's go with an N4. It's a black opal, still in the category, just makes it. And the brightness of this stone seems to be about a B3. Now, what brings the price up and saves my neck is the fact that it has some mauves and some reds and some, you know, pinks in there. And the pinks are really quite rare in comparison to most colors. So that does bring the price up just a little bit for me. So I am thinking that this stone is pretty much going to be worth what I paid for it. So the gamble hasn't made me lose any money. It hasn't made me make any money, but I think I still have to be happy because that piece was a risk. Now, when pieces look really promising and looks like you're going to make a lot of money and it could be awesome, that's when you get really disappointed if it doesn't work out, because it still can go wrong. So I'm not unhappy with this because I haven't lost anything and I've enjoyed the cutting process and I've learned just that little bit more about how the opal comes out of the opal mine that this one came from. So I'm hoping that helped you out on understanding opal a little bit more. There is a bit of a learning curve there with the body tone. You need to average that out. And pink color is so rare, it's so nice. So there's no happy dance today, but I am very happy to have not lost any money and that I have quite a nice little black opal still. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.